I'm a jolly old squire, well known round here, who came from Devonshire. And a happy life with Nance, my wife, we live from here to here. While sitting around the fireside with our children around us play, it makes me think of the days gone by about our wedding day. When the bull did prance, the cows did dance, the pigs all grunt in the sty, the dogs did bark, the pretty little lark singing merrily in the sky, the cock did crow to let folks know, the hens all cackle on the perch, the ducks and drake, what a row they make when I took my Nance to church. Oh, my Nancy was a farmer's daughter we first met on the green. She was dancing around the maypole, she was called the village queen. She consented I might see her home, so I took her slender form. I made love with her all the way until I reached the farm. Then the bull did prance, the cow did dance, the pigs all grunt in the sty, the dogs did bark, the pretty little lark singing merrily in the sky, the cocks did crow to let folks know, the hens all cackle on the perch, the ducks and the drakes, what a row they make when I took my Nance to church. I remember one fine moonlight night we were stood by the old farm gate. I kissed my Nance's rosy cheeks and said I knew her fate. On the way going home I met the old farmer, I told him what I meant. He said, well, squire, with all my heart, to your marriage I'll consent. And the bull did prance, the cow did dance, the pigs all grunt in the sty, the dogs did bark, the pretty little lark singing merrily in the sky, the cocks did crow to let folks know, the hens all cackle on the perch, the ducks and drakes, what a row they make when I took my Nance to church. We were at Rod and Martin at the time, and our next door neighbour's son got to arrange it for us. Well, he knew it all about it. Like, well, the version that we used, well, no doubt there's different versions all over the country at the time. There's about five of us, or six, I wouldn't be sure now just which to us. There's the King George, you see, the way that was the one. Then there was me, the gallant sailor. And then there was the doctor. And Belzebub, with his shoulder, a club on his shoulder, all this other business.
Now, when he went out with the mummers, yes, what did you do?
Well, first thing we went to the house we were going to, you see, knock at the door, all dressed up in that, of course, and knock at the door, and like, see the mummers act? Yes, come in. Well, in we did go. They clear a space for us, and we'd all be stood in there in a circle, you see. And then he'd sort of, here comes I, King George. King George, the dragonette, I can't think of all the versions now, but something of that there. And he'd fight anybody or anything and all this, that and the other, now. And then he'd call on somebody else, the next fella to me, perhaps. And then he'd say, he'd call on me.
Now, what did you do?
I'm the gallant sailor. Cut him and slash him is my name. With my sword and buckle by my side, I mean to enter the game. My head is not of iron, my butt is not of steel, but here's cursed and knuckle bone of a fair kick, George of the Dragon Shield. The hook did come to swords. And
you have a fake fight then?
No, I have a fake fight, and I did get a fake poke, and down I did drop. You see? Then he'd have a go at another fella and knock him down as well. We stood both of us down on the floor, knocked out. And is there a doctor to be found? Oh, yes, there's a doctor to be found. Well, what's thy fee, doctor? £10 is my fee, but £20 will I take off of thee to set these two bold champions free again. Then he called in Belzebub. I'm out on Belzebub, on my shoulder I carry a club. In my hand I carry a can, and I think that I'm a jolly old man. And then he would call on the gallant sailor now for a song, and that was me, of course. Johnny O'Kai, yes.
Well, would you like to sing that?
It's all comic. There's nothing else but a lot of nonsense attached to it. Well, this is the story of a pretty little nigger. His whiskers were of a curly nature. His hair stood up as straight as a poker, and the girls all called him Old Johnny Oker. Now, Old Johnny Oker went to town the other day. His horse fell down and his cart ran away. So he ran up the hill crying, stop, 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 then fell from the bottom right to the top. Now, old Johnny Oker went to bed the other night. He blew himself out instead of the light. When he awoke next morning to have a look around, he found himself dead with the house burnt down. Well, Johnny's wife went for a walk the other day. She got her wooden leg, a foot in the clay. She was in a sad fix, there is no doubt, for she had to fetch a shovel to dig herself out. The doctor was sent at the case to have a look. He put it down in a greasy old book. He declared it was a broken limb. Then he ordered Johnny Walker to rub it with gin. No, old Johnny Walker thought it was a great sin to rub his wife's leg with all that gin. So he emptied it down his thirsty old throttle and rubbed his wife's leg with the empty bottle. No, old Johnny Walker went for a bathe down the river. This is the end of that poor old nigger. He would have been saved, there is no doubt, if his lungs been longer than he could have walked out.
That's a nonsense.